we can see a program as a succession of program states. Each program state consists of several variables with values. As a program executes, it processes these states and transforms them into new states, for instance, by reading variables and writing variables. This is the normal mode of operation. Now, however, since in the beginning we have a normal input and in the end we have a failure, there must be a defect somewhere in our program that actually causes the problem. So let me assume that this statement we're executing here actually has a defect. What happens is that now, when executed, it introduces an error in the program state, which we call an infection. This infection is now being propagated, possibly to other states, and eventually becomes visible as a failure towards the user. What we get in here is actually an entire cause-effect chain. You see, these failures, which is an infection, is caused by earlier infections, which again is caused by earlier infections. And if we are at a state where the infection has no further origin, that is, the input state is sane and the output is infected, then we know a statement that was executed at this precise moment, which caused this transition from sane state to infected state, this is the statement which caused the infection. This is the statement which has the defect. When we're debugging now, we need to identify this cause-effect chain. Not only do we need to identify it, but we also need to break the cause-effect chain. If we can break this cause-effect chain from defect to failure, then we're done with debugging. So all of this looks very simple. However, in real life, it's much more complicated than that. To start with, not every defect automatically causes a failure. It may well be that the defect causes an infection, which later simply is not propagated as a real-life infection just as well. So the infection is not propagated and never ever becomes visible to the user. It may not even cause a failure at all. Or the statement with the defect may not even be executed. Or only under very specific circumstances may it actually cause an infection and later a failure. This is the problem of testing. You can execute a program again and again, never have a failure, and still have a defect in there. However, if a program fails, that is, if we actually see a failure, then we can always trace it back to the defect that causes it. So if there's a failure, we can always fix it by following back the cause-effect chain. But then the next problem is these states are huge. So over here we have 12 variables. Cute. In reality, we have 10,000s of such variables. And not only do we have 10,000s of such variables, we also have 10,000s of steps between defect and failure. So tracing back the cause-effect chain can be much, much more complicated than it is in this simple picture. The longer the cause-effect chain, that is, the longer the time we have to cover, the more states we have to cover, the harder it is to debug it. And also, the larger the state, the more we have to search for an infection. Again, this makes debugging harder and harder. It's like finding a needle in a haystack, except that the haystack sometimes is larger than any haystack you'll ever find on Earth.